This isn't Margie. She had to go let the dogs in because it started raining. But, oh, here she is. This is Margie. And this is Disney Updates.
Hi, Mike.
So, and we have
Disney News.
Disney News, yes. Hey, Mike. So.
Hi, Mar.
Hey, Mar. But, are you ready?
Hi, Sandy.
Hi, Sandy. Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I guess so.
All right, here we go.
It is really boring.
Yes. All right. Starting off with what we didn't do last or on Monday, which is the only one we have. All right. So it says, what it's really like inside a Disney character's costume head. What do you think it's like, Margie?
Hot.
Hot, hot, hot.
I would guess. I mean,
asking a Disney park character performer, especially one of the mascot characters, aka anyone who's actually face you cannot see, if they're hot inside their costume is the number one stupidest and unoriginal question you can ask. First of all, yes, of course, it's hot inside a Disney character costume head.
Hi, Kevin.
Chances are they're jumping around in the Florida or California heat and layers of fabric for the sakes of your magical experience. So please restrain yourself from asking this. I don't, who would ask that?
Never know.
So, says, of course, you're still curious about what it's like inside one of those heads, but you don't want to tick off the character performer or ruin the magic for your kids. So here's what it's really like to be inside some of the Disney character costume heads from anonymous entertainment cast member sources who have really done it. So here we go. Disney's character costume head types. First of all, there are a few different types of heads to consider. Based on the Disney character, the costume head will have a certain shape. The three generalish shapes, in my own simple terms, are round, like Mickey Mouse, elongated, think of Pluto, and magnet, like Mr. Incredible.
I don't know.
So it says there's also an articulated version of character heads, meaning the eyes can blink and the mouths can move because of controls the performers have attached to their hands. Let's leave that out because those are generally used for special events and stage shows rather than run-of-the-mill meet and greets.
Well, bring it up.
They used to, right? The articulated Mickey.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Number one, the round head. Friends with round heads, including Disney characters like Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Chip and Dale, Stitch, Winnie the Pooh, and more. Basically, any character whose costume head shape sits pretty equally balanced above their body and shoulders. It says, generally, the performer inside uses the character's actual eye area to see out of. The visibility is not wonderful in any head. The visibility areas are blended into the visual appearance of the character's eyes. It's either tinted plastic or a one-way mesh that the performer can see out of, but guests cannot see into. This head type is relatively straightforward to put on and take off. Performers tuck their hair into hoods or skull caps, place their own head into the head's inner setting, and secures a chin strap. Next up, the elongated.
Mike says, if you want to know how what it's like to feel what like, let's see, I think the easiest way to feel what like the costume head is like in Disney, when your dishwasher's on the heat drying, stick your head in the dishwasher.
The elongated. An elongated head reaches a good amount farther out front of the performer's body than a round one does. Characters like Mickey's dog Pluto and Eeyore from Winnie the Pooh are prime examples. It's important that performers in these roles have the right height and proportions to be able to support the lopsided weight of the head safely. Oftentimes, characters with heads like this are animals and will have a line of sight through a mesh nose, tinted eye plastic, or maybe even a mesh mouth, depending which part of the head align with the performer's eye level. These heads are a bit more awkward to maneuver and get on, as the shape is cumbersome. Performers again wear hoods or skull caps and fasten their heads in the inner settings and straps. Okay, next one, the magnet. By far the easiest head to put on and take off is what I'll refer to as the magnet face.
It sounds just as it is.
The performer straps on the back half of the character's head with their hair still tucked into a skull cap, and the actual character face part is simply placed over the performer's face like a mask. It connects and stays put by strong magnets along the connect halves of the head. Usually these are for human characters like Mr. Smee from Peter Pan and Helen Parr, aka Mrs. Incredible, who see out of mesh or tinted eyes as well. The good news about this head is that it is not as much trouble to put on or remove as others, but the bad news is that the plastic fabric is significantly closer to the performer's face. Unfortunately, there was at least one incident at Walt Disney World where Mrs. Incredible's magnet face flung off from the force of the performers tripping on stage, so they're also not as secure as the traditional character's head. So, wow. Did you know that?
So, Mike says, when I used to work at Burger King, I used to wear the Easter Bunny costume. Thank God. I was not in Florida. I think the Kevin costume would be a tough one to wear. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I think so, too.
Yep.
So, fun fact, Kevin, when I worked at Little Caesars when I was a sophomore in high school,
yeah,
I got my first job. It was Little Caesars. Guess who had to be the Little Caesar man?
You had to be the Little Caesar man?
Talk about embarrassing. I had to stand out on the road there at Meridian Street and wave at people. Oh, I was humiliated.
Margie also got sent to, we weren't, understand, this is just a story I know. Margie and I did not know each other during this time. Margie also got sent over to Muncie to work at a store, and a person called in and said their address was on Needmore Road, and she thought it was a prank. Because she's like, aha, funny, Needmore Road, I got you.
So I hung up on them. Little did I know, it really is a road. And every time we're on our way to Dayton, we pass that, or
yeah, there's one in Dayton too.
It says Needmore Road. Every time I think, oh, that road got me. Lucky it was not alive and wandering up with her head.
All right. Here we go. From Yahoo Finance.
Oh, I got it. Lucky it was not Alice in Wonderland. Off with her head.
Right. All right. This is from Yahoo Finance. A mouse divided how the culture wars came for Disney adults. It says, Josie Maida embraced the term Disney adult. I've had way worse things said about me. The 28-year-old Orlando-based content creator said, life is short. I'm going to enjoy what I enjoy. Maida lives a mile from Walt Disney's World Cinderella Castle. Not quite close enough to see it from her house, but close enough that she gets to visit Disney clusters of Central Florida theme parks at least once a week. While she's there, Maida makes food-related content to share with her massive online following, like an Instagram video from April in which she twirls a pink and orange soft serve cone for the camera before having a bite. But not everything she posts is this light in nature. I'm very, very liberal. It's a known thing. I share decently liberal posts quite a bit on my Instagram stories, she said, adding that she and other creators in her network, for very obvious reasons, tend to dislike Florida's Republican Governor Ron DeSantis. There have been a lot of cases in the Disney community where people have found out that someone was super Trumpy and have totally put them on blast on Twitter or Instagram.
That's interesting, Mark.
So Maida is just one of the many people whose relationship to Disney has become more politically tinged since DeSantis, now a Republican presidential candidate in competition with former President Donald Trump, made the company his adversary in the conservative cultural war, which have since trickled down into the niche and once solidly
apolitical
fandom of so-called Disney adults. Almost oversight, Disney went from intentionally inoffensive to demonizing and right-wing media for allegedly somehow being a promoter of grooming and pedophilia, and the Disney adult superfans are left to bear the brunt of the fallout. Disney subs are mostly fun and talk about trips and changes and stuff like that. Really political, political, but DeSantis has made it political. One Reddit who heads to Disney's regularly for marathon races told Huffington Post via Reddit DM, like almost everyone contacted for this piece through message boards, they requested that identifying details not be published, but claim to be Republican who do not like DeSantis. The overall sentiment is widely shared in the active Disney subreddit community, a political purple. So I thought this was really going somewhere else, and it's not. It just sounds like a hit piece on a politician. So, all right, moving on.
When I was the Easter Bunny, someone I knew from another job, she came in and was running over, hugging me as the bunny. And when I patted her head and said, "Hello, Susie," she was shocked. How did I know? Mar says, "We have a Get Well Road here. It was renamed because a hospital was built there. The hospital's now gone, but the name stuck around." Yeah. Oh, my word. Excuse me.
All right. This is coming from robreport.com. Rapper Little Yachty, never heard of him, dropped $100,000 on a date at Disney World, and it didn't go well.
Well, I would be mad if my date didn't go well at Disney.
So it says, the most magical place on the earth didn't turn out to be all that fun for Little Yachty. While appearing on a Safe Place podcast with popular live streamer Kai Cenat, the rapper said he treated a woman to an expensive trip to Walt Disney World, and things didn't work out between the two. Though he admitted he was trying to show off for his date, Little Yachty said he would never do it again.
Kudos to him for saying he would never do it again.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mar. And I hope it does. I hope he does too.
The overall of that trip wasn't tricking, wasn't for her, but it was to go big. And I kind of went a little insane. The hip hop artist explained that thing specifically is, I spent $100,000 to go to Disney World, take someone to Disney. I regret it because we weren't dating and it just didn't go nowhere. Yachty added, but it was fire because it was my experience. It was crazy.
Mar says, Little Yachty, is he happily ever Yachty's son?
No, I don't think so. I don't think it's Yachty. I think it's Yachty. You know, it's Y, what is it? Y-A-C-H-C-H-T-Y. Yes, Yachty.
Where? Oh, I see. Yeah.
So the pricey trip included a 2-day stay in the lavish presidential suite at the Ritz-Carlton Orlando. It had like a movie theater, Yachty said. The couple also didn't have to worry about transportation. They were driving us in a car. We didn't have to drive to nothing. The rapper revealed that he arrived for the experience via a private jet with cost of $35,000 alone. The hotel room set him back a cool $50,000, and he estimated that he spent $15,000 on the actual visit to the theme parks.
What the heck did you do for $15,000 at the theme park? And what hotel did you stay at to spend $50,000?
So Cenat, clearly shocked by the sum of money dropped on the trip, asked if he wasn't doing well enough. In response, Yachty, I guess that's how I should say, Yachty. Little Yachty. Yachty quipped, "I'm a 7-year musician. You're going to get there." The rapper who released his 5th studio album, Let's Start Here, early this year, isn't the only theme park patron who has had to sell out a lot of dough. Disney World raised its prices last December and they're not likely to fall anytime soon, as Disney CEO Bob Iger recently told CNBC that he wasn't concerned that visits were too much for visitors to pay. Disney World, where Disney brands lives in the most sublime form, I still believe that it's an incredible experience. It's a very, very popular business and product. It's very successful. Pricing is not an issue, the executive said. So,
you know what?
What?
Maybe next time we'll go on a double date and he can ask us.
Little yachty.
$15,000. I don't know what you did. Mar says that makes that date a very expensive call, girl.
Little yachty.
Think of how many hungry kids that would feed, or homeless people that could have. Yeah, but I agree with everything you're saying. I just am trying to figure out where he stayed for $50,000.
Well, he told you.
Where was it at?
It was, what was it? It was at the.
Sorry, I don't remember him saying where.
Yeah, he said where. It wasn't at one of the resorts. Ritz-Carlton.
For 2 days? Orlando.
Yes.
No.
Okay, Margie.
$15,000.
It was the presidential suite.
I get that. Okay, but 2 days in the park and $15,000?
I don't know.
Okay. Maybe Disney will give DeSantis a tour of the Utilidors and Huey, Dewey, and Louie will tell him to tie him to a wood post and dress the indentation and burn him at the stake.
How's come you're sitting so far away?
I'm not in my chair. Hold over.
You're not in frame. Gosh.
Hello, can you all see me now?
It's like I got a trainer. All right, up next.
Kind of sounds like he was disappointed that he missed out on the hooker part of the deal. Ding, ding, ding.
All right, this next part comes from Barrons.com. Disney has at least 6 major problems. Bob Iger doesn't have to be one of them.
He doesn't have to be. I don't want him to be, but I'm starting to wonder if he's going to be.
All right. Disney World may be the happiest place on Earth. No, Disney World is the most magical place on Earth. Disneyland is the most happiest place on Earth. But Disney shares have taken investors on a disappointing roller coaster ride in the past year, leading many to jump off.
And we have to pay to read the rest.
Okay.
Ta-da! Thank you, Barrons, for your lovely...
Yes. Why put them on here?
Yeah. Game costs more than the Star Wars Hotel. Yeah.
What's that?
The Ritz-Carlton.
Yeah. Well, the presidential suite. So.
I just need a room with a bed, a shower.
Okay, Marge. All right. Some people will live differently.
Would you live differently if you had that kind of money to blow?
No. I mean, you know, sometimes you want to blow money on yourself. Probably when you have that kind of money, yes.
I don't think I could.
If money was no object, you could just...
I just don't see paying that much money to sleep in a bed.
Okay. I'm sure if you're staying...
Hello, Florida freaks.
Hey, Al.
Go ahead.
It's Al.
I know. Huh. Finish what you were saying.
What?
Oh, no. You said something before you said, hey, Al.
I don't know. This comes from clickorlando.com. Orange County man sues Disney after falling off Haunted Mansion ride. Man seeks over $50,000 in damage, lawsuit says. What do you think, Marge? He fell off. He's suing. What's wrong?
You should have written that out, Mike.
So, an Orange County man is suing Disney after falling off a ride at Magic Kingdom earlier this year, according to a lawsuit filed Monday morning. The lawsuit states that in April, the man was trying to get on the Haunted Mansion ride to join his wife. However, in the process of getting onto the ride, an employee hit the emergency stop button, causing the ride to jolt and the man fall off the ride, the lawsuit shows. The lawsuit claims that the man suffered severe and permanent injuries due to the fall, and so he is seeking over $50,000 in compensation. That is all it says. What would you say? Mm-hmm. I know what I would say. Cha-ching.
Mm-hmm.
That's one hell. That's a lot of money and one hell of a story right there. You know what I'm saying?
In Cali?
Yeah.
Is that where it was?
I don't know.
That's what he's asking you, I think.
No, I don't think it's in Cali. I think it was. It says it was from Orlando. So it must be right there in Florida. Moving right along. I thought these stories would be a little bit longer than this. They don't seem to be that long. This comes from Margie's favorite. AllEars.net. Everyone is wearing these shoes to Disney World, and you should too. What shoes do you think they are, Marge? Mm-hmm. If they're what I think they are, I'm going to be upset. When considering what to pack for your upcoming Disney vacation, shoes play a key role in ensuring that you stay comfortable all day long. Trust us, blisters have totally ruined an experience or two for us while on a Disney World vacation. The All Ears team and our readers have some opinions when it comes to which shoes are the best to wear to Disney World, and we're here to share those opinions with you. So what do you think are the best shoes, Marge?
I have no idea.
Go to everyday walking shoes. Don't most people wear everyday walking shoes?
I don't know.
So that's one. What do you think the next ones are? Go to shoes for comfort and fashion.
I don't think those would be comfortable at all.
No. What we're looking at, hold on, I'll pop up so you guys can see what we're talking.
I take my blue Nikes. What Al says.
So yeah, Chuck Taylors are nice, but you feel like you're actually walking straight on the ground with these.
They are my Disney shoes, he said. His blue Nikes.
Yeah. So, what else they got? Flip flops. I've wore flip flops. It's not bad. Unless it's a long day, and sometimes, and the wrong flip flops, you can actually hurt.
Those look like they would be pretty comfortable.
Probably. Sandals. I've wore sandals before. And that's it. So they're talking about walking shoes, sandals, flip flops. These look like slippers. Do people wear slippers?
Those are just like. Slip on shoes. That article has my shoes as number 3, Croc sandals. They have good arch support. Yeah, we talked about that for the plantar fasciitis. I always say it wrong. Plantar fasciitis. There we go.
What is that?
That's what I get in my feet. It hurts. Al says I'd rock some Converse boat shoes. I wear Converse to the parks, Sandy says. Crocs are springy and comfortable.
I just wear the Skechers I've been wearing for about 5 years that still haven't fallen apart.
Say again?
The Skechers I've had for about 5 years.
You need a new pair though. They're getting there.
How long have I had those?
For a while.
Yes. All right, moving on. All right, we got some Halloween lounge flies. Margie loves Halloween. So, see every new lounge fly coming soon for Halloween. Margie can't wait. So, let's get started. Starting up with Minnie Mouse Candy Corn Cosplay Mickey Backpack for $80. I need to zoom out. Yeah, there we go. Woohoo! What do you think?
No.
All right. Next, we have the Mickey and Minnie Mouse Candy Corn ear headbands for $30. No. This is also from WDWinfo.com. Up next, we have the Mickey Mouse Pumpkin Light Up Mini Backpack for $90. It lights up, Margie.
I just don't make me like it.
The Mickey Mouse Pumpkin Zip Around Wallet for $40. The Mickey Mouse Ghost Glow Mini Backpack for $90.
Absolutely not. That is... Ew.
The Minnie Mouse Spider Mini Backpack for $80. The Minnie Mouse Spider Crossbody Bag for $70. Margie?
No.
You could at least say something.
I don't.
Minnie Mouse Spire Glow Accordion Wallet for $30.
No, I don't. I just don't like them. I don't know if it's like how big this stuff is. Like, those are not.
The Mickey and Minnie Mouse Spider Ears Headbands for $30.
That backpack's pretty cool. The Ghost Glow Backpack for the win.
How about the Stitch Shop Minnie Mouse Pumpkin Balloon Crossbody Bag for $110? Why?
Oh my word.
How about the Stitch Shop Mickey and Minnie Mouse Pumpkin Balloon Ear Headband for $30?
Those are actually cute, but I'm not willing to pay that much for a seasonal person. I don't know if it's like how big this, like, look at that, how big it is.
This is a Nightmare Before Christmas Jap Pumpkin Glow Head Mini Backpack for $80, Marge.
No.
How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Jap Pumpkin Head Wallet for $40? How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Oogie Boogie Glow Cross Bag for $70.
I don't like it.
How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Town Hall Mini Backpack for $90?
I'm going to have to say no.
How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Town Hall Zip Around Wallet for $40?
Nah.
How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Scary Teddy Presents Mini Backpack $80.
There's too much going on there. No, definitely not.
How about a Nightmare Before Christmas Scary Teddy Card Holder for $20?
No.
How about a Stitch Devil Cosplay Mini Backpack for $80?
No, I should have just left the room. All
right. How about a Stitch Devil Cosplay Zip Around Wallet for $40? How about a Hocus Pocus Binks plush mini backpack for $90?
If I had to buy any of them so far, that would be the only one.
How about a Hocus Pocus book cross body bag for $70?
No.
How about a Hocus Pocus Winfred Sanderson Cauldron crossbody for $70?
No.
Hocus Pocus Sanderson Sisters House mini backpack for
$80? No.
Hocus Pocus Sanderson Sisters House Glow Zip Around Wallet for $40? Hocus Pocus Poster Glow Mini Backpack for $80?
Nope. How about there are too many choices?
Are you even looking?
Yeah, I'm looking.
What about that one?
No.
How about, oh, what about that one? Pooh and Piglet Halloween light up.
I don't like how big this stuff is, I think. That's the problem.
You don't like how big what is?
If it was just a plain backpack with like pictures of Pooh and not like.
Well, that was it.
I don't know.
Margie's a stick in the mud. All right. Are you ready for this, Margie?
Sure.
This is from WDW News Today.
Sandy says, I'll take Binks.
Binks? Jar Jar?
No.
A rumor. Disney Treasure will feature the world's first Haunted Mansion bar and lounge. What do you think of that, Marge? Calling their spirits wherever they're at. While the Disney Treasure from Disney Cruise Line is not set to launch until sometime in likely late 2024, we are starting to hear rumblings of the details that will make this ship different from the first ship in the Triton class of ships. The Disney Wish, while the Wish featured the highly publicized but critically disappointed Star Wars Hyperspace Lounge, the Star Wars theme bar will not be present on the Disney Treasure. Instead, in that space, on Deck 3, will instead likely be home to the world's first bar and lounge themed to the Haunted Mansion. How's that sound, Marge?
Mm-hmm. I will probably never see it because I don't.
Well, the Haunted Mansion has become one of the most beloved Disney attractions of all time since first opening at Disneyland Park back in 1969, as yet to permeate other venues in the realm of theme entertainment. Pirates of the Caribbean has inspired restaurants, hotel rooms, makeover, boutiques, and even an entire evening of entertainment aboard a Disney cruise line. The Haunted Mansion has mostly been relegated to rides and the occasional nearby shop at most Disney parks. Pirates of the Caribbean does also have a blockbuster film series to thank for some of the additional offerings, but there's still a severe lack of Master Gracie and friends beyond their spooky estate. So, the Halloween season as such have given us Haunted Mansion themed food and beverages of offerings, but there's never been a culinary and cocktail home for the 999 Happy Haunts. Should it come to fruition, this bar on the Disney Treasure would immerse guests in the realm of the supernatural, offering a space filled with props, special effects, and other assorted Disney magic that will surely amuse any Disney park fan. While I'm sure many will wish for there to be a version on land, this will certainly be a strong reason for many to want to book a cruise. Do you want to book a cruise now, Marge?
Not really. Mar, I never noticed that till just now.
What's that?
We call her coordinated.
Coordinated?
Our collars, our shirt collars.
Oh, that's an accident. We never do that on purpose.
Never.
All right. Moving on. You don't think we'll ever go on a cruise?
I mean, I should try it at least once, but I don't know what I'm scared of. I mean, I know what I'm scared of. I just...
Drowning?
I am scared of drowning.
Why?
I don't want to die like that. I just want to die peacefully in my sleep.
I don't think you really get to choose how you die.
You're right. You probably don't. But that's... If I had to choose, that's what I would choose.
So... All right. This is from DizDining.com. Disney puts a stop to live-action Lilo and Stitch. By now, it's no secret that the latest Disney movie trend is a live-action remake, but unfortunately, these live-action movies don't seem to strike the fancy of most fans. In a theory, to a live-action remake of a beloved Walt Disney Animation Studios movie can add something new to the story, solve issues that are now deemed culturally offensive, or solve any glaring problem with the original film. So... As for the original Lilo and Stitch movie, there's nothing that needs to be fixed. Lilo and Stitch isn't culturally insensitive and may actually be one of the most diverse and culturally considerate films in Walt Disney Animation Studio history. The story has no gaping flaws or plot holes, and the general consensus amongst many fans is that the original film is perfect as it is. As a result, audiences are mostly skeptical regarding a live-action Lilo and Stitch. But in an ironic twist of events, Disney has put a pin in the upcoming film. According to a report by The Hollywood Reporter, the ongoing SAG-AFTRA strike have affected the productions of the upcoming Lilo and Stitch remake. The Lilo and Stitch remake was originally scheduled for a Disney Plus release in 2024. Now that the filming has been interrupted, an actual release date is currently up in the air. Lilo and Stitch stars, how do you say that?
Mia
Kilaha.
Kilaha.
Kilaha. As Lilo. Sydney Agudong as Nani. What's that?
These comments. So Mike says, one thing you must do in the parks, charge your charge card, wrap it in paper, then foil over it so scanners used by thieves can't get your card info. Al says, I would choose eating myself to death. Italian food, mostly. Mar says, Margie and I think so much alike. No cruises for me. Mar says, Al, you are so slim, it would take years for you to eat yourself to death. I don't know if you say Johanna, and I have been on 3 cruises, all Carnival Line.
Oh, okay. So we got those. Zach Galifianakis as Jumba, Bill Magnuson as Pleakley, and Chris Sanders, who's returning as Stitch. If you don't know who Chris Sanders is, so Chris Sanders not only Chris Sanders is basically the guy who came up with the Stitch idea. He is the style that every animator had to draw in was Chris Sanders' drawing style. Hmm. Chris Sanders later on left Disney and went to DreamWorks. So I don't know if Chris Sanders is back or if they're just having him come back if they were going to do this movie. So
I do fear the depth of the water in the ocean. That, yeah. Like, I'm... How do I say this? When we go, like, we've been to the Gulf of Mexico, and we've been to... Is it the Atlantic that we were at?
Gulf of Mexico.
When we were at Tybee Four. Island. But Tybee Island, right?
Tybee Island, what about it?
We were on the Atlantic, right?
Yes.
So you can't... In the Gulf, you can go out waist deep and still see your feet.
Yeah.
So you know what's lurching under you or lurking mm-hmm. under you, right? You go to the Atlantic and you can't see, and I don't like that. Like, it scares me.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't ever want to go to anywhere except where I can see. That's why I don't swim in lakes and ponds and, you know.
All right.
Oh, Al says deep water freaks me out or freaks him out, so yeah. I guess I'm just scared that the ship would sink. I don't know.
That's weird.
I'm just saying. Let's finish our news.
All right. Here we go. This is from WDW News Today. Crane arrives for Mirabelle's meet and greet construction at Magic Kingdom. So a crane has arrived at Fairytale Garden in Magic Kingdom to retheme the area for a Mirabelle meet and greet. Merida from Brave has been meeting in Fairytale Garden next to Cinderella's Castle for over a decade. She relocated to Liberty Square on July 9th. So the small crane is just barely visible in the courtyard beyond fencing and scrim. Kind of hard to see, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
We still see Brave tapestries on the stone wall. The courtyard will be decorated to look like Madrigal home, Casita from Encanto. Says green scrims were already erected around the meet and greet location. Now a green wall is in front of the gate. The green shade has been removed from above the meet and greet stage. The shade was striped in two different shades of green. Shades of green. It's down the road.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to look up the weather real quick.
So the wires that held it up are still in place. Okay. Before Fairytale Garden held the Merida meet and greet, it was home to Rapunzel and Flynn Rider. I don't remember that. Do you? Huh?
What?
That it was Rapunzel and Flynn Rider?
I do not.
Mirabelle meet and greet is set to open this fall.
There's a hole in the chin.
There's Mirabelle. So this has to be like the most lifelike character you can get to. That they can actually...
It was perfect.
Yeah, that looks like Mirabelle and actually... Mirabelle from Canto Film has previously only appeared for meet and greets at Walt Disney World during Run Disney races. I did not know that. Did you know that? Mm-mm. Interesting, Margie. Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
All right, moving on.
Absolutely, Mar.
What's that?
The Titanic movie has given us PTSD for cruising.
So, coming up, Marge. WDW News Today. Enhanced Space Mountain onboard photo introduced at Magic Kingdom. So the new onboard photo design aboard Space Mountain. So The old style is pictured in the sample above, while Twitter user Brooke Geiger McDonald shared a look at this new graphic design below, which can now be accessed by any guest with Disney PhotoPass. So this is the old design.
Yeah, but look how happy they are.
So you're going to say they don't look happy in the next
one? No, like, you can't really see, like, I don't know, like, the camera's not looking right at your face, but you can tell that boy's just, like, oh.
And here's the new one.
I don't know if I like that one.
Why? It looks like you're actually going through.
I don't know.
So, it says Disney PhotoPass is an add-on. Of course, we all know this, but, wow. Is that what they're expecting Space Mountain to look like in the future? What was that?
Get Margie and me a life vest. And me is the correct grammar. No one would say, get I a life vest.
In other Space Mountain news around the world, Tokyo Disneyland will be receiving a new version in 2027 as Walt Disney Imagineer has teased a new story that will tie in with the SEA story from the Tokyo Disney Sea, which is, what does SEA stand for, Margie?
Keep reading and I'll tell you in a minute.
All right. At Disneyland, the blue light tunnel effect is almost completely burnt out after transitions back to its normal theme from the Hyperspace Mountain Star Wars overlay. Oh, look. I like that t-shirt. Looks like it's for children, though.
Something, I don't think it's Enthusiast Adventures.
No, it is the Society of Explorers and Adventures.
Explorers, Society of Explorers and Adventures. Okay. I just don't know if I like the new photo. I don't know.
All right. I don't think I got enough.
I have something to talk about.
Okay.
You want me to do it now or wait?
Let's do this one. Okay, this is from DizDining.com. Logging into your Disney account just got a whole lot easier.
I don't think it's ever easy.
If you're anything like me, passwords are not your friends. I just can't keep them straight. A password for my Disney World account, a completely different one for my Disneyland and Disney Cruise Line accounts. Well, we don't have that problem. So, And then there's Shop Disney. Do you know how many times I've had to change my Shop Disney password? I can never remember it. That all changes today. Says, good news, you already have an account since you already used your email to sign up for one or more services within the Walt Disney family of companies. You can now log into Alani Resort enter your current password to log in. So it says, now one password is all I need to remember. Disney has streamlined its login process across all of its sites. When you log into any Disney website, now you'll see the exact same screen and prompt for logins. That means it's not a one and done, no need. The new streamlined login will apply across the family of Disney sites included.
It's now a one and done, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this includes Disney World, Disneyland, Tokyo Disney, Disney Vacation, Alani, Disney Cruise Line, Play Disney Parks, Golden Oaks, Club 33, Shop Disney, Disney Reward, Disney Gift Card, ABC, National Geographic, ESPN, Marvel, and Star Wars. So, if somebody hacks into your account, then they can get into your Disney World, or Disneyland, or Tokyo Disney. That's just silly.
Spaceship Earth is closed as of yesterday.
Oh, wow.
One of my college certifications is in language arts with grammar. Oh, no. Ow. I hope they don't change it too much. So, I don't know if any of you have been to, I'm sure.
This is what you're going with.
I'm so happy.
All right.
So when we were with Kevin to Florida, yeah, we drove down.
Yeah.
We never been to a Buc-ee's.
Yeah.
It was great. I like Buc-ee's.
Yeah.
And everybody said, make sure you get the, are they called beaver nuggets?
Beaver nuggets, yes.
Beaver nuggets.
Yes.
So we were, Haley and I were at Rural King. Sunday. And
I don't know if they have Rural Kings.
Rural King. Okay.
So I don't know if they have Rural Kings
anywhere.
Well, I know we have them here, but that doesn't mean they have them down south. I don't
know. Anyway, it's like
a Tractor Supply.
Kind of, but they have.
If you don't have a Tractor Supply, then it's like a Rural King.
But they have like clothes, they have farming stuff, like
right,
feed, all yes. that. Anyway, they had these things.
Well, yeah. See,
what's a rural king?
A rural king. It's R-U-R-A.
Okay, so Mar, you love beaver nuggets. Okay, so we're in the store, right? We're at the register, and I'm like, oh, Haley.
Not royal, rural. You let me R-U-R-A-L.
Hold on, let me grab this.
Rural.
What's up, bud?
Like, I don't, it's, yeah, it's like a tractor supply is what it is.
Okay, so I was so ecstatic that I found these things, and it says Caramel King Puffs. So I brought them home.
So they're basically, they're the beaver nuggets.
I brought them home to Chris, and I said, hey, you really like those beaver nuggets, right? And he goes, yeah. I'm like, well, now Rural King sells them, but they're King Puffs. So I don't know. I just found it fascinating because we like them. Anyway.
Ooh.
Okay, come on. You're going outside.
Yes, yes, as in country. Yes, rural. I don't know. I see that sometimes it's kind of weird because something that people around here have, you just think, like Margie, she just figured they were all over the country. It's not true. I mean, it's just like Pizza King. Pizza King's only Indiana. You have other people like, what is Pizza King? So, okay. But that
you can't call them beaver nuggets. Yeah. So we have what I say, King Puffs.
You can if there's no Buc-ee's in Indiana or Ohio. All right. We got some merchandise. I think Margie will like this merchandise just a little bit better. Maybe. I don't know.
I'm not a lounge fly person.
This isn't lounge fly. All right. This is from WDW News Today. Mickey and Friends Silhouette Corksicles now available in Walt Disney World. So, we are starting with Mickey and Friends Silhouette Blue and Pink Corksicles for $34.99. Let's get to them. Oh, wow.
Yes, very. It is more.
The front features the logo of two companies and is predominantly blue and pastel pink. Encircling the top are some of Disney's most iconic characters, Mickey Mouse, Pluto, Minnie Mouse, Daisy Duck, and Donald Duck and Goofy. The design is similar to a Yeti white claw holder and similar in size. It's intended to hold a can, cup, or bottle that can fit inside, wrapping around with a relatively tight rubber material. The top ring is removable. Though there is not actually a lid completely enclosing it. So it's more of like a, what would you say? It's more like a cozy, right? Can cozy or something like that?
I don't know.
All right. So next up, the Mickey and Friends Silhouette Black and White Corksicle for $55. Says larger than the first version, this tumbler features the same design aside with its color being black and white. This version does not hold other containers, rather the liquid goes directly inside.
That's what I would prefer.
You would rather prefer that?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Oh, I would love it. That would be perfect for me.
The lid features a retractable sipper along with a carrying handle.
And that is why, because my job at work does not allow me, I don't have a place to put my water bottle. I have to have one with a handle so I can hang it on a hook.
Right.
So that would be perfect.
I don't know. I don't think we've ever owned any Quirksicle products, have we?
No, and I don't think I will because I'm not paying $55 for one. That's craziness.
Maybe you'll find a nice one somewhere else.
I did. Well, it doesn't have a handle, but...
Did we miss?
No, we did those.
We missed.
No.
You can say no all you want, but I'm looking for a certain one and it isn't here.
Oh, we didn't do the top left one.
Right, but what... I'm going to have to go back and look for it. Because what the picture is, we don't have that story on here. That's what I'm talking about.
Very good.
I don't think so. I'm looking real quick. Just 1 second, please. Did we accidentally skip over it, maybe?
We read all of those.
Let me see if I can find it. Just give me 1 second. Let's see. That here it is. There? Yeah.
Looking at the gold too on that water bottle, I thought it was a grill you plug in. Hey, Crazy Mike, Margie found merch she liked. I did like it. It's just, that's expensive.
Yeah. All right. All right. This is coming from WDW Magic or WDW News Today. Disney still surveying guests for possible return of Voyage of the Little Mermaid at Disney's Hollywood Studios. So they got an actual picture of the survey. So Voyage of the Little Mermaid, boring, immersive, and sensitive, personal favorite, iconic, dated, not familiar, none of these.
I don't know what I think.
Moldy.
AFK, I'm getting a snack.
This hear me. First instance since the last time we heard that it was filled with mold. Moldy.
Oh.
I don't know if that's true or not, but.
So. I would just say.
It says the survey asks what we thought of every Disney Hollywood studio attraction. We had the option to select multiple of the following options. Boring and immersive and sensitive, personal favorite, iconic and dated. Users could also select not familiar and none of these. What makes you say Voyage of the Little Mermaid is iconic and personal favorite? I think it's all right, but I think it needs updated. What do you think?
Probably.
So, it says Voyage of the Little Mermaid is a lot. We know what that is. I think. I hope everybody knows it's a live action show there at Hollywood Studios. So, I don't know. It's been sitting empty for too long. So either you're going to bring it back or you're going to put something else there.
I would say just get rid of it.
So.
And put something else there.
Right. We just don't want to see something sitting empty that could be used for something else. That's my theory. What do you say?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's get to the last story. Are you ready, Marge? Mm-hmm. Do you want to read it?
You want me to read it?
I don't care.
The ride trend you won't like in Disney World right now. While there are several things that go into a Disney World trip, rides are an important aspect to many. That's why we are constantly tracking the wait times and ride closures so that you know what to expect on your vacation. Last week, we saw a major drop in the wait times, but this week, things have changed, and you probably won't be happy about it.
Oh, so this is just our wait time report, isn't it?
Uh-huh. So we don't know how to read it. That's it.
So at the Magic Kingdom. And I've been hearing that the parks haven't been busy here lately.
I heard today, I read that they were down yesterday and people were complaining they only got to ride 2 hours or two rides and the lines were 2 hours long. But there were film crews there filming around the carousel and there was another one they were recording around.
So I don't know. I can't remember where I heard this. And I'm guessing they're done filming this movie. But I've been told that the new Purge movie takes place at Walt Disney World and they actually filmed there.
Oh, I don't know. They said something about this one was doing a commercial maybe.
Really? So.
I really don't, like, it's just somebody's post. Like, right. They were there and.
So, except for this one, the highest one was, Seven Dwarves Mine Train for 85 minutes at Disney Hollywood Studios. The highest one was Slinky Dog Dash. Which is really weird because I like Slinky Dog Dash, but I just don't see it being up there with like Rise of the Resistance and Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, but I guess it is. At Epcot, it was Frozen Ever After. Wow, that's a surprise. Frozen Ever After at 53 minutes. Really, 53 minutes? That's not really a bad wait either. No, huh? Disney Animal Kingdom. Is Avatar Flights of Passage at 95 minutes.
I'm trying to see if I save something real quick.
So. So the question is, really what you got to figure out. You know what you got to figure out, Marge?
Hmm.
What you got to figure out? You figure out which what park has, let's say how many rides are in a park, right? Mm-hmm. How many hours is the park open? All right.
Okay.
All right. And do the hours, let's say if you spent 1 hour in line for each attraction, mm-hmm. would you be able to make it through before the park, through all the attractions before the park is over, closed? Mm-hmm. I think some of the smaller parks like Hollywood Studios, I think you could do it. I think obviously Animal Kingdom, I think you could do it. I don't know about Magic Kingdom.
I don't think you could do it at Magic Kingdom.
I don't think so. But you got to think also, there's also going to be times where you're not waiting an hour in each ride, for each ride though, too. So let's see. Did you have an article about the new live musical Rogers in the theater at Disney's California Adventure? Marcy found a cheap flight to go out to California to see it. No, I haven't. I haven't even heard of that.
No, today we read where the...
Oh, today is Dole Whip Day.
Oh, yeah, National Dole Whip Day.
Yeah, Margie wouldn't make us Dole Whip.
I didn't.
No. So, it depends where you sit on the train. On the roller coaster, you get more thrilling rides, like back of the most of the time. She liked it. Oh, wow. So, no, I haven't even heard of that musical, Marm. Rogers, so...
What did I read today? We read the guy who made the Disney music park music past.
Yeah. I don't remember what his name was.
I'm trying to find it and I can't.
So.
It's driving me crazy.
It's driving me crazy.
Why is that like that?
Why is what?
So I click on my group and it says free beer and Powerade.
Ooh, that sounds awesome. Hydrated and drunk.
Well, I can't find it, so.
All right. So, I think that's going to do it. Yeah. So, we will.
Oh, the musical's about Captain America.
Oh, so Steve Rogers. I gotcha. Okay. Wow.
Nice. We'll have to look it up.
Yeah. But I think it's going to do it, right? Mm-hmm. Right? So we didn't have very many adventures. We put one out this week. We're not going to obviously able to get one out for next tomorrow because we're here. we are heading out this weekend for some adventures. We already planned out what our adventures were.
I thought we did, but I think we can probably, if we could get enough, I would like to get enough where I could have one whole weekend to just get things done here.
Okay. But other than
that involves like both Saturday and Sunday going like two or three places a day.
So, all right. But other than that, so I guess we have no plans so far for this weekend. So we need to come up with some.
Well, I know where we want to go.
Right.
We just have to decide if
that's... Well, I really wish we could have went to the one. I know, but now it's out of way because nothing really in that direction. So, but one of the places we... The state park was planned. We were going to go to a place called the Sunken Gardens that's in Huntington, Ohio. And basically, it's a park that was placed at the bottom of a stone quarry.
Yeah.
So what it was, the stone quarry was, they were done using it and everything. And it was an eyesore. And the city decided to do something about it. And they put a park in it. So we were going to go to it. It was called the Sunken Gardens. But... there's nothing in that direction we're going to be heading towards, so there's no reason for us to go to it. But
today is 65 years since the moon landing. Houston, the Eagle has landed. I'd love some Dole Whip. I'm looking for it in the grocery stores. Yeah, I'm going grocery shopping tomorrow evening, so if I see it, I'll let you know where I found it.
Oh, wow. So, you got anything else? No.
I'm sorry I don't like merchandise.
How about if you look at merchandise more through the eyes of not somebody who's buying it, but through the eyes of somebody who appreciates something nice?
I do appreciate stuff that's nice, but if I don't like it, I don't
like it. Well, if you don't like it, that's fine.
I don't know.
So, all right, but that's going to do it. So thank you guys for joining us. And I will, like I said, we'll be back Monday for more Disney updates. And... think it's it. So I hope y'all have a good evening. We'll see you later. Bye.
Bye.
Tell them bye, Margie.